Morning students, welcome to our bio class. Now previously we have completed the topic female and male reproductive system. We have discussed about the different parts of the reproductive systems and their function, both in female and male. Now today I am going to start the topic gametogenesis. Now what is gametogenesis? It is the production of gametes for sexual reproduction, which takes place in germ cells present in primary sex organ. Gametogenesis is the production of gamete for sexual reproduction takes place in germ cells present in primary sex organ. Already we know what is primary sex organ. Primary sex organ means testes in male and ovaries in female. Now, gametogenesis is controlled by gonadotropic hormone, which is secreted by pituitary gland. Now, totally, if we say gametogenesis means gametogenesis, it means it is production of ova, that is oogenesis, and production of sperm, yeah, that is spermatogenesis. So today we are only going to discuss spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis means production of sperm. Spermatozoa are produced in seminiferous tubule. Where? Seminiferous tubule. And this spermatogenesis is completed in two stages. First, formation of spermatid, and second is metamorphosis of spermatid, that is spermiogenesis. Okay, formation of spermatids and then metamorphosis of spermatids. Now, in formation of spermatid, three phases are there, that is multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. Okay, so formation of spermatid is completed in three phases, that is multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. During multiplication phase, the primordial germ cells, primordial germ cells, we can, it can be represented, written in the short form, that is PGC. Okay, PGC, it divides continuously by mitosis. It divides continuously by mitosis to form diploid spermatogonia. Diploid spermatogonia, it means it has 46 chromosomes. Each spermatogonium is diploid, obviously, and it contains 46 chromosomes, which again divides mitotically. See, first primordial germ cells, which is diploid, divides mitotically to form diploid spermatogonia. Now, diploid spermatogonia divides mitotically into two primary spermatocytes. Now, obviously, it is dividing mitotically two primary spermatocytes are formed. So, it is haploid. Now, next, this phase is will be, now from here, the phase of growth is starting. During the phase of growth, the primary spermatocytes undergoes enlargement in the size and it is prepared to undergo meiotic division or maturation division. Okay? So, each during, now, This is prepared for the maturation phase. Now, what happens during the maturation phase? During maturation phase, the primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division and second meiotic division. After first meiotic division, it gives rise to secondary spermatocytes. And in which the cells remain connected by cross bridge, means by cytoplasm. Now, they further undergo second meiotic division, which results in the formation of haploid spermatids. Now, haploid spermatids, I will send you the figure also. Four spermatids are formed. Okay? Four spermatids are formed. Now, after this, this whole process, first multiplication phase, second growth phase, and third is maturation phase. See, what is the result? Spermatids are formed. And total how many spermatids are formed? Four haploid spermatids are formed. Clear now? Now, next is metamorphosis of spermatids. Now, metamorphosis of spermatids, or we can say spermiogenesis. It is the conversion of, see here, conversion of spermatids to spermatozoa. What is metamorphosis of spermatid? Conversion of spermatids into spermatozoa. It is termed as spermiogenesis or metamorphosis. It takes place in cytoplasma of Sertoli cells. Takes place in cytoplasma of Sertoli cells. Now, there is no cell division here. Clear? Only the weight of gamete reduces and development of structures for motility and penetration takes place. Now, spermatogenesis takes place due to the further changes in the hormones. Obviously, we know that. Firstly, what happens? There is increase in gonadotropin releasing hormone. Gonadotropin releasing hormone, which acts at anterior pituitary gland. Anterior pituitary gland. It also stimulates the secretion of LH, or we can say it is also termed as ICHS. Clear? And helps in the secretion of FSH. Now, increase in, again I am explaining the whole process. Spermatogenesis is due to the increase in gonadotropin releasing hormone, which acts on anterior pituitary gland. It helps in the secretion of LH, that is luteinizing hormone, or we can say interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Interstitial cells stimulating hormone, and it also stimulates the secretion of FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. Interstitial stimulating hormone stimulates and synthesizes the secretion of testosterone. It stimulates the secretion and synthesis of testosterone. So obviously we know what is the function of testosterone. We have learned testosterone stimulates the process of spermatogenesis. And FSH acts on Sertoli cells and stimulates the secretion of some of the factors which helps in spermiogenesis. Clear now? Now here, this whole process we have discussed spermatogenesis. In spermatogenesis, again we have studied two steps. First is formation of spermatid. Second is metamorphosis of spermatid. The whole process, formation of spermatids, we have studied three phases: multiplication phase, growth phase, and maturation phase. And then formation of, after formation of spermatid, we have learned spermiogenesis, formation of sperms or spermatozoa. What are the factors which affects or which helps in spermatogenesis? So if anyone has any doubt, you can contact and learn all the topic and note down the points. Thank you.